Random House Audio presents One for the Mojave Kid, adapted from the short story by Louis L'Amour.
Before the railroad came, Hinkley, Texas was a dusty little cow town. Just a saloon and general store to serve the three neighboring ranches, owned by Burton Holstock and his two sons. Then the surveyors arrived, and all too soon came the track layers, train crews, accountants, and company executives. The railroad brought 2,000 new people to Hinkley, and 1,000 more came after them. They were the merchants and the saloon owners, the prostitutes and gamblers, the con men and the thieves. They all came to service the railroad workmen and to separate them from their money. Needless to say, there was crime, so the local merchants decided to appoint a marshal. The man they finally decided on was Ab Kale, a young cowhand from Burton Holstock's ranch. Now, although Ab was an educated man, he was known as being one of Holstock's toughest hands. The townspeople and the men from the railroad company liked him because he was married to Amy Holstock, one of the family, so to speak. Marshal Kale's first official act was to post a notice at either end of Main Street that, starting the first of the week, anyone with a current arrest warrant from anywhere would be locked up and held for trial. Now, this was not common practice at the time. Usually, peace officers only enforced laws that had been broken within their jurisdiction and closed their eyes to crimes committed elsewhere. Ab, however, wanted to run the criminals out of his town, and he wanted the potential troublemakers to go with him. Hinkley was not going to be one of those wide-open railhead towns anymore. No one paid much attention to this new ordinance until Monday morning, when the new marshal began rousting men who matched his wanted posters out of bed and throwing them in jail. In the days that followed, he had several gunfights and several men were buried on Boot Hill. In the weeks and months that followed, Hinkley became a much quieter place. Eventually, work on the railroad progressed far enough so the construction crews were moved on to another town. Hinkley was still and would always be a railroad town, but the marshal's job became easier. Then Ab got a new wanted poster in the mail. It was for a man wanted for robbery and murder. He knew that because of his decision to enforce all arrest warrants, he would have to try to arrest this man if he ever came to town. He also knew that due to the man's reputation, Ab would probably have to kill him. Because of his marriage to Amy Holstock, it was a situation that would haunt Ab Kale until the day another young man, Riley McLean, came to town.
Stand clear! Clear the rails!
Evening, Marshal. Out for a stroll?
Just checking for vagrants.
Have a good evening, Marshal. Charge all yours. Make way! Clear the rail!
Hey, you there! Stop!
You hold it right there, boy. Well, now, I got a hunch you're not holding a ticket to be riding in the boxcar.
No, sir.
You headed anywhere in particular?
Well, where am I?
Hinkley, Texas. You running from something?
No, sir. I'm hunting a job.
Yeah? What's your name?
Riley. Riley McLean.
Riley McLean. No, I don't think I have that name on my poster wall.
Well, then am I free to go?
I said I don't remember the name. That doesn't mean I don't have the face. Come on, son. Let's go back to the jail. In here.
Marshal, I know what I did was wrong. I couldn't afford a ticket, but if you give me a chance, I could get a job. I could pay the railroad back.
You have a trade, Riley?
No, sir, but I can do most anything.
Most anything?
Well, almost anything. Not much I haven't done, that's for certain.
Can you give me a good reason not to arrest you?
I've done no one any real harm.
You rode the train without paying. That's against the law.
Well, I did that, sir. But as I see it, that train was coming on with or without me. My weight didn't slow it down none.
No, I don't suppose it did, Riley. You got me there.
I don't mean to argue. I know you have a job to do.
I don't always like it, son. There's a pump out back and a barrel.
Marshal?
You're in need of a bath, son. You'll have to prime that pump real good. It hasn't worked right in years.
Yes, sir.
You can sleep the night in the cell. It's a hard bed, but it beats the floor of a boxcar.
Then I'm not under arrest?
No, Riley, not today. Come morning, we'll see if Hinkley is ready for a man who can do most anything.
Now, Ab Kale knew that when a man says he can do most anything, usually he does almost nothing well. If a man has a trade, he's proud of it and says so. Riley McLean had no trade. He was tall and thin and clumsy looking. Yet Ab reserved his opinion, and it was well that he did. When Ab got down to the jailhouse the next morning, he found Riley slowly reassembling the pump from a pile of parts on the floor.
What the...
Oh, morning, Marshal. I just about got this pump working. Bad seal was all there was to it. There's some coffee on the stove.
Well, yeah, so there is. And there's been a mop to this floor.
Yes, sir. I figured I owed you for the bed.
Well, you make a fine cup of coffee, son. You think you can mend harness?
Well, yes, sir.
Well, Ed Crowley has some work to be done over at the livery. You can start this morning.
Now?
After you get my pump back together.
I'm finished with this bridle, Mr. Crowley. I needed to mend the bit.
You have the blacksmith do this?
No, sir. I did it myself. I hope you don't mind my using your tools.
Oh, that's a fine job, Riley. It's real fine. You thinking of staying on here in Hinkley?
I'd like to.
Well, there might be a job with John Holdstock. The marshal wanted me to send you on over. $2. Day and a half's pay for a day's work. I appreciate that mended bit.
Well, it's mighty generous, Mr. Crowley. Thank you.
Afternoon, Ed.
Oh, hello, Ab.
Riley.
Hello, Marshal.
I talked to John Holdstock. He's got work for you at his ranch. He expects you tomorrow.
Thank you, Marshal. Thank you, Mr. Crowley. I'll be going now. Goodbye.
How'd he take, Ed?
He's not afraid to put a hand in, that's for sure. Fixed this bit right here in the shop. Smith couldn't have done a better job.
Well, that's fine. Real fine. So now we'll see how long it lasts.
People who came west were an independent lot. They were escaping from prejudice and cities so crowded you couldn't see the sky. A man came west to be his own man, to be free. Ab Kale understood that. So, as Marshal of Hinkley, he walked softly. He kept the peace by taking care of things before they got out of hand. He was liked because he didn't let the law become a problem. He was testing Riley McLean by handing out all the hard work he could find. He figured Riley would become a member of the community or hop the next freight out of town. Either was better than locking him up.
Hello. You must be Riley McLean.
Yes, sir.
John Holdstock. It's a pleasure. Well, we're raising a barn here. It's not a hard job on the mind, but it beats hell on the back. So grab the other end of that saw and dig right in. Give it a pull. After you finish tonight, the marshal expects you over at his office. Now push.
Evening, Riley. How are you?
I'm fine, Marshal. My hands are blistered, but my spirits are up.
Axle grease.
Sir?
For your hands.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.